Finally, we look at what the cost of a matrix-matrix multiply is. Not only is this useful because you know how much computation is required to perform a matrix-matrix multiply, but it also allows you to remember what the cost of all the other operations are that are special cases of matrix-matrix multiplication. We're just going to use this drawing right here of the different matrices. A has m rows, n columns, B has m rows, k columns, B has k rows, and n columns. We're going to determine the cost of a matrix-matrix multiply in a couple of different ways. First, let's go back to how we came up with how to compute matrix-matrix multiply in the first place. We started by saying, look at a column of C, and that's computed as A times the corresponding column of B. Okay, so we do C sub J is equal to A times B sub J. So we can then ask ourselves the question, what's the cost of computing one column of C? Well, that's the cost of multiplying this matrix times this column. How did I teach you to think about what the cost of a matrix vector multiplication is? Well, I told you for every entry in A, you end up doing a multiply and an add. Well, strictly speaking, that would be true if we added to C, but among friends, that's good enough. So what's the cost of a matrix vector multiplication? Well, it is a multiply and an add, times the number of entries in A, but this particular matrix has m times k elements. So that's the cost of computing one column of C. How many columns of C do we have? N. So we must multiply that times n. And if we rearrange that, we see that the cost of a matrix-matrix multiplication is 2 times m times n times k. Okay, let's compute it another way. What did we just learn about how to compute a typical entry in C? Let's call it gamma sub I j. Well, we know that that has to be computed as the inner product or dot product of the corresponding row of A with the corresponding column of B. Okay, so this would be the jth column of B, and this would be the ith row of A. So it's computed as A sub I tilde transpose B sub J. What's the cost of a dot product or inner product? Well, for vectors of size n, it's 2n plus or minus. Well, some would argue it's n multiplies and n minus 1 adds, and therefore it's really 2n minus 1. But among friends, we'll just call it 2n. Okay, however, the size of our vectors in this case is not n, it's k. So we know that the cost of this is 2k. Now, how many entries are there in matrix C that we have to compute this way? Well, m times n. So we must multiply this times m and n. And if we rearrange that, we get again 2 times m times n times k. So that's the cost of a matrix-matrix multiplication. Later we're going to talk about how many memory operations are required. That's better done in the setting of discussing high-performance matrix-matrix multiplication, which is an enrichment at the end of next week.